A new shock to the scientific world, and really to all of us. It is about the mysterious extinct human species, Homo naledi. The new discovery suggests that this species may have intentionally buried its dead and carved symbols above the graves on cave walls long before the earliest evidence of burials by modern humans. Working in incredibly tight spaces in the Rising Star Cave system in South Africa, a team of researchers last year made these and many other discoveries about this ancient species, and our next guest was part of that expedition. Here he is describing one of the engravings just moments after he discovered it.
I can't believe what we're seeing, and we're seeing scratch marks, sort of what we call petroglyphs, which are in pictures or carvings carved in the rock. But look at the scale of these things.
Well, I'm so happy that we're joined now by the man you just saw in the tight cave, National Geographic Explorer in Residence and world-renowned, okay, how do I say this, Paleoanthropologist. Okay, Paleoanthropologist. Dr. Lee Berger joins us now. He's the author of this book, by the way, that comes out in August. Cave of Bones.
It goes, I get PTSD looking at that image. You know, I almost died coming out of that.
That is very claustrophobic to begin with. But how did you almost die?
It was, well, to get in that, you have to go down about a 40-foot shaft that is, gets down to 7.5 inches.
No.
It probably averages about 9 inches.
Absolutely
the entire
not.
Time.
Guess how much weight he lost to do it?
55 pounds.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because you wanted to see this so much.
I had to test some questions. We had discovered these burials, or we realized we had burials in 2018. We were on this National Geographic expedition. We were down there. I saw the burials, but I've only ever seen this thing through video. And we had these questions over COVID, and we could not get them answered. Only 47 humans had ever been in there. And so I decided I needed to get in there and test them. And when I got in there, I started making these discoveries. You know, our missions were always very focused. Saw those symbols, blew my mind.
What do you know what they mean? And this is
no,
a dumb question,
and,
but
and
like,
that's
what,
an important point.
How can you conclude what you think they are?
This is not a human species. They have a brain a third the size of ours. It's about the size of a chimpanzee's. And they're carving symbols 150,000 years before humans even think of doing that. They look familiar to us. Crosses, boxes, yep. Triangles, hashtags. They don't mean Twitter. I know that. And yet, we may never know what they mean. They were made for other Naledi, not for us.
Right. But one thing we do know that I really took away from what I read about the work that you've done on this is that what you discovered erases the belief in human exceptionalism because of the size of our brains.
You know, we have told this story since for thousands of years. Why are we different? We want to make ourselves different. One of the last things we had is this big brain. That just died, just like the Homo naledi died, but with this evidence, that died.
Why?
We are not exceptional.
Can you explain that more?
Yeah, so humans have got this narrative that our big brain supercharged us, made us different. Let's do culture, let's do symbols, music, art, all the things that we like to separate ourselves from the animal kingdom. Of course, animal studies have shown us, you know, that's not true. Whales do incredible things. Corvids, you know, crows are brilliant. But now we know that neither were we exceptional in that brain. The brain doesn't make us whatever it is we are. We now see Homo naledi doing the things that we held as the only thing we had left 250,000 years ago.
Your energy and level of energy and passion tells me that you're not by any means done. What's next? In terms of your research, how do you move this forward?
Firstly, we're bringing this to the world. We're going to engage the entire scientific community in how to test these hypotheses. This is science. It's ongoing. There's a lot more to discover. We're also going to be asking the world, what do we do with this? What do we do with discovering the first non-human species that had our capabilities? This is a special place to them. They took the dead of their kin mm-hmm. into these remote areas and buried them. What should we do? Do we just destroy it in the way we humans tend to? Or do we, you know, take care here? I think it's a special, it's almost our first contact moment, you know, the real first contact
yeah.
moment.
Paleoanthropologist Dr. Lee Berger, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Really fascinating, and congrats on the book.
Oh, thank you.